This is the Pearl River Delta in southern China. An inspection team is about to get to work checking the installation of the final section of the longest submerged sea tunnel in the world. The underwater inspection team was established especially for this project, a project that will redefine the meaning of made in China. The tunnel is part of a brand new type of bridge built at a time when China is emerging as a global leader in bridge building. It's the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge. Once completed, it will be the longest cross-sea bridge in the world. Built to last for 120 years, it will link Hong Kong, Macau, and the Chinese mainland, becoming a symbol of the one country, two systems policy.
我们建的是一个连接，是个 link.
Innovation is key to the project's success.
因为我们最初选定方案的时候，根本没有现在这些施工机具设备，也前人也没有这样去做过.
What sacrifices were required to make this mega project a reality?
他们有好几年都不能回家，对，回去小孩都不认得他们了。The
project has given birth to a new generation of engineers. What does this bridge mean to them? 有的从二十多岁到三十多岁，我觉得应该和他的人生啊，和我们的人生分不开的一个事业。For a decade, engineering teams from every corner of China have been quietly contributing to the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge.
It's cooperation between three regional governments. I mean, it's not easy because we have different systems for project management. And even for the technical specification, the standards are different. It is a sign for the three regions to be one family, the target of the project. We want to build a world-class sea crossing link, best to serve the user and to become a landmark.
At 55 kilometers, this is the longest cross-sea bridge in the world. It's made up of 22.9 kilometers of steel bridges, four man-made islands, and a 6.7 kilometer long tunnel submerged at a depth of 40 meters. With the completion date approaching, engineers are working against the clock to lower the last tunnel section into place 40 meters below the surface. The section is the length of two football pitches. It's the longest tunnel section ever laid under the sea anywhere in the world. Chief Engineer Lin Ming and his team are tasked with moving this 80,000-ton giant to its designated position. It's a risky operation, which raises the question, is this bridge really worth it?
If this bridge is connected, the Zhuhai-Macao
这个想呢，它的这个经济发展的这个潜力呢，它会在后面的慢慢的显形出来。
The bridge, by spanning the Lingding Channel, will join the biggest cities in the region, creating one vast metropolitan district, the Hong Kong-Macao-Guangzhou Bay Area. This area already contributes 10% of China's GDP. The engineers are working flat out to complete the bridge and make their contribution to boosting urbanization in China.
7-8天。
Moving the tunnel section just 1 centimeter requires a whole fleet of ships to work together in unison.
我们一共准备了13艘船，这里有一艘，这里是4艘，然后这里这样有4艘，一共这是我们正常的8艘。今天呢，我们想加快速度，今天啊，我们第一次做，你们都会发现我们在前面还会增加2艘船，加快速度。
But Lin Ming is playing a complex game. On his chessboard, 40 ships and almost 300 workers are on the move. Danger lurks at every move. More than 4,000 ships pass through the Lingding Channel daily. To reduce the risk of collision, Guangdong's Maritime Authority has ordered that the area be cleared. With all traffic temporarily banished from their route, Lin Ming's team can make their move. They have to transport the section 3 kilometers offshore. Out at sea, it takes 3 hours to move the section just 200 meters. Lin Ming is gambling that his more powerful fleet of ships will increase the speed. However, the immense forces involved mean that the slightest false move can cause an accident. A wire may snap, endangering the life of the crew. Fortunately, Lin has years of experience to draw on.
We just started doing this first time. I was a new driver. I had a feeling of this first time on the road. 我们自己就造了一个设备，然后就给他开出去了，然后又开上大街了。原来我想请个教练，但人家要的钱比较多嘛。就我那时候要我们请个教练，人家要我们就是用人民币要，当时要10几亿嘛。我们没有教练，让我们承担了很大的压力，或者说付出了很多的那种辛苦。
Lin's innovative approach seems to be a success. With the new ship formation, the tunnel section has covered half the distance at twice the normal speed. But then, there's a problem. The team face an 8-hour wait. It will be a test of their morale. But this is nothing new to them.
对对对待命，
待命，
现在就停下来了啊，就等着掉头，好吧？
我知道，我在这等一会儿，等他一个来小时，他溜走了，往里
去了。或者等那个我们计划不动，还是明天早晨再对接嘛？
Behind every engineering marvel lie the sacrifices of countless people. The Great Wall is a symbol of Chinese civilization and the nation's perseverance in overcoming challenges. This is Anlan Bridge, part of the Dujiangyan irrigation system in Sichuan, believed to have been built in the 3rd century BC.In the course of over 2 millennia, it has been destroyed several times in natural and man-made disasters. However, it's always been rebuilt to provide safe passage over the raging river. The history of Chinese engineering is that of constantly overcoming challenges. Many generations after Anlan Bridge was built, what can we say about the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge and the people building it?
我们大概在500个人左右，都是从全国各地汇集过来。中国目前啊发展的这个重点的地方都是在东南沿海，这样子的话就是说，我们内地啊或者其他地方的工人都往这边来汇集。
我们东岛。在整个港珠澳大桥，它是离岸边最远的一个工作面。当时我们东人工岛还没有形成，这儿还是一片茫茫大海。最开始的时候，我们是住在这个工作船上，那么我们一个很小的工作船住了200多个人员，就是根本就没有活动的空间。
Soon Hong Chuan and his colleagues have had to make other sacrifices.Soon was introduced to his future wife over the telephone. They married very soon after meeting for the first time. Before that first meeting, their only contact had been via video calls. His wife is also working on the bridge, but she was assigned to another work site on the far side of the sea.
我一般是到他工作的地方去，如果我们两个人都有空的话，会一起回老家看望父母，家还是小时候的那个家乡。
唱生日歌你为什么不唱啊？
为什么就不唱呢？
Still, some of the workers have it easier.
幸运的，我本来就是珠海人，这个项目又在珠海，所以就是很多人也很羡慕我，就是每天一下班看到我就说回家啦，又能回家喝汤了，多好啊！这样他们都很羡慕我，对，他们有好几年都不能回家，对，回去小孩都不认得他们了。
我们的建设事业总归会有人来做嘛，即使不是我们，那其他人也是一样要付出嘛。那别人能够坚持，我们为什么不能够坚持呢？
我觉得这种状况其实在很多地方都会有，也不一定说是我们这边的特色。当然我们这边中国是个很大的国家，我们这会有这样子的情况，但是同时他们工作他们会觉得很有自豪感，毕竟是一个这么大的项目，一个国家级的超级工程，对啊，但是当然是牺牲很大。
我感觉能够参与到这么一个伟大的超级工程，它就会不自觉地被这个项目的魅力啊所吸引，就是会有一种油然而生的使命感，
及时的去弥补
啊，对对对
对，对吧？
就是这里穿过去，穿到我们那。
Every day, over 6 million tons of cargo passes through the Pearl River Delta on ships that dock in Hong Kong, Shenzhen, and Guangzhou. Building a bridge in these busy waters will inevitably have an impact on shipping. The original design envisaged making the bridge high enough for ships to pass under it. However, not all the traffic in the area is on the sea.The bridge lies near Hong Kong International Airport. Safety regulations dictated that the bridge's towers could be no taller than 88 meters. So the designers came up with another solution, building part of the bridge underwater. Thus, the plan to build a 6.7 kilometer long submerged sea tunnel was born.Constructing the tunnel necessitated further technological breakthroughs. The tunnel would be formed of 33 prefabricated sections, each of which would be on average 180 meters long and weigh 50,000 tons. The sections were made at a facility on Niu Tou Island. Once completed, they were sealed and floated to the construction site.
These are by far the biggest immersed tunnel elements that have been used. I've come to China since 2008 when they started the project. And they started the project from scratch, developing the technologies, introducing innovations that were thoroughly tested and studied in making sure that they could meet the very stringent requirements.
But the tunnel under the sea still had to be connected to the bridge above it.The solution was to build two man-made islands. However, this presented a whole new set of challenges. It was originally estimated that building the islands would take over 2 years, much longer than the schedule allowed. Once again, a creative solution was needed. The engineers decided to drive enormous steel tubes 30 meters down into the seabed. In all,120 tubes were used to form the outline of each of the two islands. Each tube was 22 meters in diameter and 40 to 50 meters tall. These steel tubes formed the foundation on which the islands were built. Before long, a connection between tunnel and bridge was taking shape.While on the Zhuhai side, the solution was to create new land in the form of islands, in Hong Kong, land was reclaimed.
我现在在这个项目里面是一个高级一个地盘经理，从投标开始就参与到现在，差不多五年时间。那个这段项目呢，主要一共有2.65公里。其中呢，就包括1.1公里的一个隧道，再加1.5公里的一个地面的一个道路。地面道路呢，主要是建立在这个23公顷的填海区。又是呢，在机场岛上自开岛以来呢，也算是第一次在机场岛上面进行一个这么大一个截面的一个爆破的施工。
The bridge reaches Hong Kong near the international airport. The unique environment here presented the engineers with a new set of challenges. The connection is 12 kilometers long. However, this is not one straight road, but comprises a 9.4 kilometer long bridge, a 1 kilometer long tunnel, and 1.6 kilometers of highway linked to Hong Kong port. This complex connection.Was divided into several sections, which were built simultaneously.
The difficult bit in this project is that we are inside the airport island. So we have the oil fuel tank over there. On the left-hand side is the cable car transfer station. And in front, we have a light traffic road.
The Hong Kong connection could not disrupt air traffic to and from the airport, nor could it damage any of the existing infrastructure. The engineers solved this issue by building a new island to use as a transfer point. However, construction was far from easy.
Traditionally,
reclaiming land involves dredging the seabed. But this inevitably harms the environment. To avoid this, metal tubes were once again called upon to form a perimeter. However, the area is surrounded by hills, which complicated the road construction. A 1.1 kilometer long tunnel would have to be built. By building the tunnel in four sections simultaneously, it could be completed in half the normal time. For the workers from the mainland, the project offered some unexpected benefits.
我们从那个大学毕业能够过了半年直接在后来就直接来香港工作一开始肯定是有点不适应的了包括语言啊包括文化啦包括当时候其实香港跟内地的沟通和交流那时候相对还是比现在还是少的特别是在十几年前但是呢经过在这一边无论是做工程啊还是公司的各种帮助培养之下呢到现在基本上已经熟悉了香港的这个本地的文化已经融入到香港的整个文化中间
Far away in New York City, Chinese engineers are working with their American colleagues to maintain and build that city's many bridges. During their stay, they've learned a lot about bridges in America.
Those are the form for the top wall, for the back wall, and the wing wall.
This is the Garrison Inlet project for CCA. We're constructing a brand new bridge. The old bridge was built in late 1930s to early 40s. But have seen very little maintenance. What you see here, it's all brand new. We take advantage of the new technology, the new material, so they should last longer than, you know, the old bridges. Although we have to give credit to the people before us when they built the bridges.
I got all the equipment.
New York City become New York City today is because of those bridge. Okay.
From late 1800s to 1950, U.S. civil engineers create a lot of miracles, including the Brooklyn Bridge, George Washington Bridge, Lincoln Tunnel, Holland Tunnel, Grand Central Terminal, and JFK Airport. And the whole world still benefits from those engineering innovations.
But is the West still at the head of the pack when it comes to civil engineering? If so, how long will it remain there?
60-70年代以前，世界桥梁建设和技术的重心在哪里？在欧美。20世纪的60-70年代以后，到这个21世纪初这一段时间。那么世界桥梁建设的和技术的中心在哪里？日本。日本在它70年代经济起飞以后，建了相当大量的一批
世界级的跨海大桥和水道工程。那么到了二十世纪初到今天来说，可以说世界桥梁建设的重心和技术的重心在哪里？在中国了。
Over the last 20 years, China has constructed a huge number of bridges. At first, progress was slow, but it soon took off. This development is all part of a grander scheme.
For example, 1991年开工的汕头海湾大桥，1992年开工的湖畔大桥，还有1997年开工的厦门海棠大桥。都是为了做这个零点大桥做总基础储备和做锻炼人才。
就是我在上学的时候，港珠澳大桥就几乎是我的一个梦想，就没想到我呢就上学时候的一个梦想，居然在我的这个职业生涯当中就不小心就变成了现实，而我呢又有幸的话呢参与到了这个过程当中，而参与过程当中我亲历了这个港珠澳大桥整个的这个技术演变的过程。
对，
因为我们最初选定方案的时候根本没有现在这些施工机具设备，也前人也没有这样去做过。
是我们要求180度弯完了以后，整个的弯曲部位是不允许有任何开裂，如果有开裂那么就判定为不合格。所以我刚才讲了，就是这一层镀上去的膜它越厚，这个弯曲性能越难保证。
应该说我们这代桥梁人还是非常幸福的，对吧？一个是有国家战略的支持，另外一个我们也恰好赶上了有现在这个经济实力，有现在这个技术储备，对吧？我们能实现。
Engineers, however experienced they may be, have to tread carefully when attempting something that's never been done before. Lin Ming and his team are entirely focused on the task at hand. They're about to move the final tunnel section into position. Nothing on the scale has ever been attempted in China before, and nature is on their side. The current turns exactly when they're expecting it to. The tunnel section arrives at the construction site on time.
Well, 全部结束了吧？现在在开始做存放准备工作。你比如你马上看到它有些那个像拉合，我们叫拉合的，要把它拉到一块儿的一些安装啊，有些保护临时保护装置要拆除啊，然后管上面城管顶上现在还有很多为了这个拖航用的一些设施要把它拆除啊，现在用了8个大的锚嘛，还没有抛好固定的时候，它的风险是比较大的。这个横向的水流啊，它会让它移动。就假如到了我们那个白色的区域的时候，这个就是大麻烦了。
It's a race against time to install the section before the current pushes it out of position. Even if they didn't have to battle the current, placing the section in the right position underwater would still be a momentous task. Back in 2013, it took over 90 hours to install the first tunnel section.
我们没有两班人的，我们就一般人员要从头干到尾。那么中间像这个阶段的时候，我们有些人员，比如像这里操作的人员，现在他们在有些就去休息，稍微休息3个小时、5个小时，稍微休息一下。但是有的休息呢，也就是歇歇而已，是一种安慰啊。这个人不像开关呢，休息一打开工作他可能能够睡着休息一会儿，可能一点就睡不着。这其实这是一个挑战，这连续的工作疲劳，这可能也是我们这个阶段的一个挑战，整个这个3多个小时的一个挑战。 我们第一次是96小时，96个小时第一次。
Lingming hopes to complete the installation before daybreak. However, success will depend on more than just his team's ability to battle exhaustion. Subtle undercurrents could potentially endanger the entire process. Twice in the past 3 years, sudden changes in the situation in the water forced the team to suspend the installation.While Lean and his colleagues face up to their own unique challenges, below them, another team is simulating a worst-case scenario. The submerged tunnel lies 40 meters under the surface. Here, the slightest accident could spell disaster. In testing the tunnel's safety, they need to confirm that the key structure is capable of withstanding temperatures up to 1,200 degrees Celsius.They must also draw up emergency procedures for responding to an accident. The guardrails on the bridge have gone through equally rigorous testing. A range of different vehicles were hurled at the barrier at speeds exceeding 100 kilometers per hour.Back out at sea, Lingming's team is on the point of completing the project they've been working on for almost a decade. This is the last and the most crucial part of the process. Section E30 is about to be lowered into the sea. There, it will slide in between the sections that have already been installed, completing this massive puzzle at the bottom of the sea.
现在已经两个城管已经对上了，按照我们的程序呢，要检查，检查有没有一些意外的异物啊，或者有些什么情况，看看一些间隙的情况正不正常。真的是特别的顺利，而且他们我们这些工匠们操作的也特别精细，目前的感觉还可以，但是要看最后，所以我们现在还不能讲。四分钟完了以后，我们就最后进行叫压接，压接。最后我们还要再拉一下，然后进行压接。压接完成，那么这次对接就完成。
Over the last 3 years, Lean and his team have installed more than 30 tunnel sections, creating the longest submerged sea tunnel in the world. Their hope is that this mega project can serve as a blueprint for similar undertakings in the future, albeit with some modifications.
像比如像我们港座这种工程，它是没有可复制性。这个工程上用的方案，也就是说，你比如换一个工程的时候，哪怕情况类似的时候，不一定能够就是原封不动的去用它。这是对一个工程师非常重要的。
3.4万元。
但是对这种复杂工程呢，我认为啊，学的是方法，而不是一个方案，也不能叫精神，精神有点高大上，传承的是方法，思维的方法。 早就不感觉是个不仅仅是一座桥了。就我们这个团队吧，这投入的都有这个十多年了，有从30多岁到40多岁，有的从20多岁到30多岁。我觉得应该和他的人生啊，和我们的人生分不开的一个事业。
They finally completed the installation of the final tunnel section. Now the inspection team will decide if they've been successful.
今天的任务，我们是组织了这个差不多十位同志啊，那么进行一个 G30 管节跟 G31 对接好水力压接完成以后啊，那进行一个水下的一个状态检查。
管接机啊，在对接以后，它试线的时候呢，它是通过说一条一个止水带进行止水，就是防止隧道来说漏水。我们来说呢，就要检查合不合格。这次安装来说呢，有没有达到我们设计的要求？来说呢，就是深水带采用这种沉管，那么这一种方式来进行在水下来作业，应该是国内的历史。
The inspection team will dive to 50 meters below the surface to assess the installation. Each team member will collect data from several key points along the tunnel section. The data will then be transferred to the control ship, where engineers assess the findings with reference to the set standards.
好的，到达城墙面，潜水员判断方向啊，往北行进。这边看的数字是9毫米啊，请确认啊，移开镜头，你自己确认。
等一下来说。
The team has a list of things to inspect. They must determine whether the new section has aligned properly with those installed previously, and whether the water stops are functioning as they should.
可能会出现的问题有很多种情况的，比如说呢，它那个时候呢就是一个压缩的不均匀，或者说呢，止水带里面还夹带来说呢一些就是一些异物，那么这一些情况来说，它都会来说呢影响止水带和止水的效果。
The slightest irregularity can affect the performance of the entire tunnel.If a problem is found, it's up to Lin and his team to try and remedy the situation, which is likely to delay the completion of the entire project. However, the inspection team's findings are looking promising.
From our test results, the situation is pretty reasonable.就是对接啊，这家说呢，压缩这家它都是很均匀的，也就达到了一个比较高的一个水准呢，就是我们现场的判断。
Today's success is the latest of many breakthroughs that have been achieved during the bridge's construction. It's expected that the new methods and technologies they've developed will be a help to Chinese engineers in the future. But how?
我自己觉得我这一代应该是跟着现在的这个中国的这种跨越式的发展成长起来的，并不一定说港珠澳大桥超越了全世界的桥梁，我不敢说，但是我意识到了我有差距，那我想一代人不行两代，一个项目不行两个项目，只要意识到了这种差距，我相信终究有一天一定会超越它。
哦，我们现在是在我们广东长大 CB07 标的这个中山集料加工厂，现在的这个墙面铺装啊，已经进入攻坚阶段了。 今天我们主要到现场来看一下我们石料的生产的这个质量的这个稳定度。这个是 SMA 里的，
对，这一个的话就是纯用在 SMA 里面，就是 SMA 里面粒径最大的。
现在你看我们这个洁净度啊，现在你看一下，我们拿手抓完以后打开，非常干净，你看一点石粉都没有啊。就是我们能做到这么精细，我们并不是说我一定做到极致或做到最好，但是我们在我们就是说这个能力范围内，还有我们能想到的，我们尽量要把它做到最好，以我们的这种态度去保证我们整个桥的质量。
The Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge represents the pinnacle of decades of bridge-building achievement. But more than that, it's an indication of where Made in China is headed in the future. The adoption of robotic systems is one example of this. At the China Railway Shanhaiguan Bridge Group, the oldest bridge-building company in China, robotic systems have helped raise production to unprecedented levels.
I'm very proud to say that I never imagined it. This place has a broken bridge, and a broken bridge is very normal. But on the Guangzhou Bridge, I haven't found any. The Hanfeng is called this Hanfeng.一条焊缝，汽车大量的采用的都是这种机器人，而钢桥制造是没有的。这个应该是从港桩开始，也就是业主提出的，要引领这个行业技术进步。这个钢桥制造业的这行业，它的进步怎么样去引领？从加工方法。
Many people believe that the bridge has greater significance than its breakthroughs in construction methods and technologies.
We built the bridge not just a bridge or a bridge. We built a connection. It's a connection. It's a link.这个 link 不光是把三地的地理连接起来，它把我们的思想、感情，包括我们多少年来创造的优势的东西啊，都能够连接起来，包括把我们的技术标准对接，啊，把我们的规则要对接，把我们的理念要对接。
It's been a month since Lin Ming's team installed the last tunnel section. Now they're back at the site to install the last joint. When the tunnel opens to traffic, Hong Kong on the east side of the Pearl River Delta will be connected with Zhuhai and Macau on the west. This will give the bridge its symbolic meaning.
When I started, I thought I was just doing this building. But when I built it, I turned it around and looked at it, I found可能是因为我们建立一个座桥，可能带动了很多事情。比方说，因为我们做港桩，因为我们提出了这种设计的，这种理念，因为我们要实现我们这种意图，实现我们这种目标，那我们可能很多地方要改变，装备要改，是吧？材料要改，技术要改，理念要改，各个方面都要改。但是这个东西可能不是我这个眼界上的人能看得透的。
再有一个，从设计上讲呢，我们这个大桥有非常鲜明的这个景观文化 和大桥的桥梁文化啊在里面，那么看过这个大桥的他会比较认同这个观点，是吧？港珠澳大桥不是光是一个交通功能的一个人工构筑物，而是它是有血有肉的文化的载体。
所以跨粤港澳三地建立这一个桥，它的意义不仅仅是建成一个高品质全生命的世界一流的工程，它对三地的发展，而且对国家以后要造一些类似的工程，包括世界上要建一些不同的标准、不同的制度啊、不同规则的地方要建一些桥啊，怎么样来建都有很好的借鉴意义。
Some people admire the bridge's quality, others marvel at its projected long lifespan. Yet others prefer to focus on the time they spent with it.
我是毕业之后，我是进了公司，是公司分配到我来这里。我们都是惠州，广东惠州，觉得就也是广东的嘛。我觉得起码对香港、澳门、珠海三个地方都是一种联系嘛，因为香港跟澳门也分开了，跟我们大陆分开一段时间，但是现在回归之后有这座桥做联系的话，我相信我们肯定会越来越好。
这个岛嘛，包括这一段桥本身也是我们亲身经历来建设，当时确实是挺激动的，我们也是人生那个最重要的一个日子。
他五年了，我两年多。
在我们的心目中，我们每个人都有两个亲人，一个是自己的爱人，一个就是这个项目。
Bridges overcome barriers. Throughout history, they brought people closer together. The Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge connects the Chinese mainland with Hong Kong and Macau. It also connects China with the world.But this bridge does more than connect regions. It connects China's past, its present, and its future. After almost 70 years of development, China has grown from a fledgling that was only just learning to fly to a great bird spreading its wings and soaring into the sky. The concepts of Chinese standards and made in China are increasingly making their impact felt on the world stage.As for the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge, it's the latest, most impressive symbol of the Chinese dream.